हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी विल डिस्कस ऑल द सेवन कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट प्रॉब्लम्स इंडिविजुअली इन सेवन डिफरेंट क्लासेस. सो द नोटेशंस यूज्ड इन द एक्सप्लेनेशन एज वेल एज द न्यूमेरिकल्स आर एज फॉलोज. पी स्टैंड्स फॉर द प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट, एन इज द नंबर ऑफ इंटरेस्ट पीरियड्स, आई इज द इंटरेस्ट रेट. And interest can be calculated like daily, monthly, quarterly, semi-annually, annually. And this interest will be like 8%, means 8 by 100, that is 0.08. F is the future amount at the end of a year, N. Then A is the equal amount deposited at the end of every interest period. And lastly, the G is the uniform amount which will be added, subtracted after a period from the amount deposited of the amount deposit A at the end of period I. Now single payment compound amount. As I said, single payment compound amount is that you pay like a fixed deposit. You pay today and after some time what at some interest rate, what will be the future amount. So you know the P, you know the interest rate, you know the period, you are going to find out F. Please, dear students, please understand, we are not calculating interest here in these problems, neither we are calculating the period also. We are only calculating either the present amount P or the future amount F, and this can be either a single amount P or a single amount F, or it can be a equal series amount annually. Okay, so only these things we are trying to find out. So if I know the, now for example, single payment compound amount, here I know the present amount P, so I am going to find out the future amount F. So the formula, if you look at the formula, it is something like this. So you can see F, that is future amount, is equal to P in bracket 1 plus I raised to N. So here F, that is future amount, is a function of present amount plus rate of interest and the period. Okay, and we can also write it as F is equal to P in bracket F by P comma I comma N, where F by P comma I comma N is called the single payment compound amount factor. Now to clarify this, we'll take a simple problem, very old problem these are. Like, find the compound amount of rupees 200 for 5 years at 8% compounded annually. Okay, so here the principal amount is P, is 200 rupees, N is 5 years, 8% is the interest, I is equal to 8%, that is 0.08, and we are going to find out F. Okay, so what is F? F is equal to P in bracket 1 plus I raised to N, that is equal to P, in substituting the values of P, I, N here, principal amount is 200 rupees, in bracket 1 plus I is 0.08. See, please, interest, don't write directly 8%. 8 means 8, you are, then you will commit mistake. You are right, 8 is 0.08 only. And I, N is equal to 5 years. So if you calculate, it will come as 293 rupees. So this is the future amount or the compounded amount after 5 years, single amount, what I am getting. Okay. So this is like our normal fixed deposit. You go to any bank, they offer some 5%, 6%, 7% interest rate. So for a period, you keep it, and after that period, you get that amount. So this is a like a FD. Okay. So here we are calculating the future amount for the present amount what we are going to keep. Okay, the principal what we are going to get P for a number of years N with the interest I, and the formula is F is equal to P 1 plus I raised to N. Now, if you take the second case, like single payment present worth amount, so here the equation is the same. Please understand, for 1 and 2 the equations are same. Single payment present worth amount, what we calculated was future amount, compound amount. Now we want to calculate present amount, so the equation is the same. Here we calculated F is equal to P plus P in bracket 1 plus I raised to N. Here in the next thing we know the F, so we are going to calculate the P. So what will happen? F divided by 1 plus I raised to N is equal to P. Simple it is. So you have to only remember three formulas. So other three formulas automatically you can use the reverse of the same. Okay, same problem. Instead of finding F, you are finding P. That is it. Okay, so we'll see the next problem in our next discussion.